In this video, we're gonna see how to make a cool wireframe explored view for your presentation in no time. What's going on, fellas? I'm Geo and this is Geo Creations. You can find me on Instagram as GeoJerwin. Let's jump right into the video. So what's the point in doing an explored view? One, you can give a clear-cut idea about your design. Two, it'll be easier to explain your design. And last but not least, you'll end up getting a cool composition. First, we need to finish the 3D model of the design. This is an auditorium which I did for my semester 6 architecture design. Now let's decide how we need to present our design. Here I wanted to show the different levels and how it makes up the whole design. And also, if you have any unique implementation inside, we can expose it out in a cool way. So first we need to sort out our model and make sure that whatever needs to be separated are in a separate group. Otherwise, it'll be a messy job. Now create gaps between each elements. Make sure that none of the elements are overlapping because it'll be harder while post-processing. Now we need to set a scene so that it'll be easier to come back again and edit stuff. Make sure that your field of view is set to parallel projection. To do that, go to camera and select parallel projection. Now you need to select a view which looks cool. Set the view to isometric and go to view animation add scene. Now we need to export this as PDF to get the utmost quality. For that, go to file, export 2D graphics, select PDF and export it. If you can sacrifice the quality a little bit, you can also export this as a PNG to fasten the exporting process. Actually, when I did this, I've exported it as PNG because I had a slower PC back then, and this model has a ton of geometry, so it's really hard for this PC to handle this file. What I exactly did is, I've exported each element separately without disturbing the axis to get the utmost quality. To export all the scenes at once, we need to export it as an animation without transition. To turn off the transition, go to Windows, Model Info, and in the Animation tab, uncheck Enable Scene Transition. Make sure if your background color is neutral so that it'll be easier to manipulate it in Photoshop. To know more about tiles and workspace customization, go check out this video by clicking on this I button or check out the link in the description. For now, you can just select a simpler style like Shaded with Texture from the Styles tab of the default tray. Now to export all the scenes at once, go to File, Export Animation. In the Save As Type drop-down menu, select PNG or JPEG. Click on Options and set the resolution to Full HD. And now select a folder and hit Export. Now open the folder, select all, drag and drop into Photoshop. Now create a new file, set the size of your canvas and set the resolution to 300 if you're going to print that. Let's bring in the full view just for size references. Now it's time to remove the background from the rest of the elements. Open the tab, remove the layer lock, select the background with the magic tool and delete it. But if you do like that, the holes inside are still left out. To get rid of that quickly, go to select color range. Pick the background color and increase the fuzziness till you start seeing white on your subject. Now just hit delete. Make it as a smart object to avoid loss of data while scaling. Do this for all your flows. And now bring it in the main file. Align it according to the reference. Now try to overlap them a little bit. And reduce reduce its opacity by mask. To do that, select the layer and click on the mask button. A white box will appear near your layer's thumbnail. Click on it and start painting black on the areas you need to erase. To bring it back, just paint white over it. Now you may think, like, what if I just need to reduce the opacity of a particular area? For that, you need to set the color accordingly. Black erases and white brings it back. Apparently, a gray shade will reduce the opacity. You can also play with the flow to control it. Now select all the layers, right click and link it, so that if you move one layer, all the linked layer moves along with that. Make them as a group and let's name it Explorer View. Alright, now it's time for the final step. Before that, make sure to leave a like so that YouTube pushes this video to more people. Okay, now we're gonna give a wireframe effect. Let's assume the background is a dark gradient. Now you need your drawing to be in a lighter shade, and also a wireframe look gives even more aesthetic value to the presentation, unless you've added some extra annotations on it. To give that effect, we need to use a gradient map. For that, go to adjustments, gradient map. Now create a clipping mask to the group below by pressing Ctrl Alt plus G. Click on the gradient map layer and go to properties. Click on this bar here. The left bar represents the darker areas and the right side represents the lighter areas. Tone in the middle, just drag the slider by pressing Alt. Now you can also choose a color for the midtones. Now continue with your presentation and create an awesome composition. And I wish to know what you think about this video. Please let me know in the comments below, and don't forget to join the community by subscribing to the channel. Signing out for now, catch you guys in the next video. See ya.